Alrighty, this is going to be a quick video on setting up internal props. I'm going to try and run through this quick and keep it to the point. If you already know how to export parts or do IVAs, you're pretty much 80% there. Same 3D process, do your assets, do your textures, import them into Unity. The only thing you need to do for an internal prop is make sure you set your object to the internal space layer. That way the internal props will, this piece will not be rendered on the portrait camera. If you set it to Kerbals, then it will be visible on the portrait camera. So if it's going to be a background object, then it might be better to put it on the Kerbals layer. That way you can see it in the little portrait camera on the lower right. If it's going to be something that's going to be in front of the Kerbal or in between the portrait camera and the Kerbal, then it's probably better to put it on internal space. That way it's not going to block the face of the Kerbal when the little portrait camera loads up. The portrait camera is embedded in the Kerbal, and there's not really, well, there is an alternate camera object you can use, but I don't really like it because it's a lot more wobbly than the embedded Kerbal camera. I'm going to do the indicator panel. That's kind of a moderate complexity internal prop. The simplest one you can do is the camera switch. If you watch the IVA video from before, you already know how to do that. Just put in any collider object, set it to trigger, and when you click on it, the camera is going to be positioned at that transform in the direction you point the blue arrow at. So you can put that internal camera switch on anything or nothing at all. Any trigger you put that module on in your internal space, you can double click on it and get a camera. So that's the easiest, simplest internal prop to set up. So now we'll look at this indicator panel. The downside of doing props is that there is no documentation on how any of the stuff works. It's not like part modules where a lot of people have done stuff. So, and the squad, the stock config files are pretty explanatory, whereas the internal modules, the config files are not that obvious to figure out. Sometimes things are pretty clear, sometimes it's not so clear. So take, for example, this compass. You can kind of tell what settings are there, but if you think it's a nav ball, that's pretty okay. That's fairly clear there too, but there's no comments in any of these prop configs to kind of help explain what these settings are. So the best way I found is that you can dig up the assembly C# library from I believe it's KSB data. KSB data managed. So you can dig up this assembly C# and put it into a say Visual C or MonoDevelop. MonoDevelop comes with Unity and it's free. You can load that up as your project reference, and then you can get a look at the internal modules and see what settings there are to help you figure out how to configure the internal prop. The one you want is assembly C#, not the first pass one. So this is the one you want. And here I've got MonoDevelop set up. And honestly, I don't remember how I got to this point. So you're gonna have to look at some, find some other tutorial to help you get to this point, setting up your development environment. But what you do is you set up your project and you add the assembly sharp DLL to your reference, and you can double click on that and you get this new panel, and that lists all of the, I don't know what these are called, I think they're called, okay, it's a class, right? So each of these class is, could be a module, or it could be something internal to KSP, it could be an internal module. And what you want to do is, you know, if you're doing props down here, the internal, and you open up the prop and you look for the base type. If the base type is an internal module, then this is something you can call or you can use as a in your internal prop config file. So we can look at the, let's see. So here's the compass, right? Internal module is internal compass. And then we can look for internal compass, right? Base type is an internal module, and you click on that. And already you can see there are a lot more settings you can use here, right? The config only sets the name and the indicator name, but there are other settings that you can use to experiment and see what changes. I haven't used any of these, so I don't know what they are. You know, axis sets the up direction of the compass. That way you can, it, by default it's Z, you know, you can change it to a different axis and the compass will be, will start up in a different orientation. So I'm going to stop before it's too obvious that I don't really know what I'm doing, and then come back to this indicator panel here. So first thing, I want to find the internal indicator panel. There we go. Base type, it's an internal module, right? So it's something we can use in our prop config file. Right, there's the module name, internal indicator panel. You want to match that up to your module name. Right, this, all this stuff, all these syntax is the same as your part config and your internal config files. Model node works here as well. Of course, you start with a prop. Module manager stuff will work here too. So if I uncomment this out, then this particular prop will only load if module manager does not detect. That's what this explanation sign means. It means it needs raster prop monitor to not be installed. But that's a different topic. I'm digressing. So indicator panel, indicators, you can, you know, basically I just copy this out of the squad's stock indicator panel and change the object names to the ones in my particular prop. So we can look at the stock indicator panel here. All right, same setup. All I did was change the object name, the name. So in mine indicator panel, I have these objects, right? These things get light up by the module, right? It's emissive material here. And then that's not the right one. There we go. And then color on, color off. That's pretty clear. Easy to figure out what they do. When the value is 1, the emissive is set to that value. When the value is 0, the emissive is set to that value. So you can use that to change the colors. And I've done some of that. I'll show you in a second in the game. And the other thing is that sometimes the internal modules will have settings, but they're not really hooked up to work. And the indicator panel is an example of that. As you can see here, indicator values, there are 12 values, but in actuality, in game, the module is only set up to update 8 values, right? High G-force, stage ready, gear, RCS, SAS, and kill rotation. These two are linked together, so when you turn on SIS, this one, the kill rotation indicator is going to light up as well. So that's pretty much all you need for setting up internal props. And you know, the previous video on placing props in the IVA, you export this. Same way with the part tool export script, and just make sure you have it on internal space or Kerbal's layer, depending on what you need, and export and set up the configs. And prop configs start with capital letter prop, and then once it's placed in your game data folder, you will see it in here. Right, hit refresh, and it's going to go through all the prop config files and link them up in here. So there's my indicator panel. I can spawn that. There it is. Another useful thing you can do to figure out how squad set up their internal props is to spawn one of their props. I'm going to do the compass. Something a little more complex. Let's do the nav ball. Alright, so already you can see the root orientation of the nav ball, right? And it has this script. But what you can do is just remove this component and you'll be able to select the sub objects inside of this prop. And that's going to help you make the connection between the model and the config file for the prop. So if we open up the navball config here, right, so navball name is navsphere, which is the ball itself. So now you know if you're going to set up your own navball, this is the variable that you assigned. You assign the nav sphere to, right? This name can be anything you want, as long as you set this variable to match this name. And icon up, I don't really know what that does. There doesn't seem to be anything in the model that uses it. So. And then if you do a group select, you can see all the other sub-objects and what they're called. So the useful ones here are the markers. You can see their name. And then in the config file, you can see the variable and the object name, right? So prograde vector is right here. And the variable name is prograde vector name. And in addition to that, you can come back in here, open up internal nav ball, and you can see what these settings are. So just to show you, I've got the indicator panel already placed in here. It's just a matter of changing your object name, right? If you have, something like the indicator panel, which lights up individual lights, then you need to have these individual objects that the module controls. So RCS is the object in your model, RCS. And in game, I'm pressing the R key here, RCS, that turns it on and off. Same for the SAS and gear. Right, again, for the squad's indicator panel is only half complete, and you're only going to get indicator for high G-force, gear, RCS, SAS, and stage. So yeah, that's pretty much all the information you need to set up an internal prop. You can the ones that you can. That the ones that actually does something, the altimeter, radar altimeter, vertical speed indicator, these axis indicators. You can look through the C-sharp assembly to see what the settings are, in combination with the looking at the config files, and then you can spawn them in Unity, break it up, and see what's inside of the props. So all those three things together should be plenty to get you rolling on making your own internal props. So yeah, that's it. And there's that throttle from before. Anyway, thanks for watching. It's hopefully that was pretty quick and painless and to the point.